Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pi My Life Up. In this video, we'll be showing you how you can stream games from your PS5 or PS4 to your Steam Deck. To achieve this, we'll be using a software called Chiaki. Chiaki is a free and open source PlayStation Remote Play client. It maps the controls of your Steam Deck to match that of the PlayStation controller. It even has full support for the touchpad and gyro functionality of the PlayStation controller. This means that you can play games that rely on these functionalities while using your Steam Deck. For example, in the Astrobot game, you can simply swipe up on your touchscreen to replicate swiping up on the PlayStation controller. To set up this functionality, you will need either a PS4 or a PS5. Additionally, you will want your PlayStation Network profile to be public. This will make setting things up a bit easier later on in the guide. Now, with your Steam Deck in your hands, press the Steam button to bring up the Steam menu. Next, select the Power option, and then select the option labeled Switch to Desktop. As the Chiaki software we are using to remote play from our PlayStation is not available through Steam itself, we will need to switch to desktop mode to install it. Once you're in desktop mode, click the little shopping bag icon in the taskbar to open the Discover Software Center. This software center allows the easy installation of numerous pieces of software, including Chiaki. With the software center open, switch to the search tab and then click the search box. You will now want to bring up the on-screen keyboard by pressing the X button on your Steam Deck. Now, type in Chiaki, and then either press the Enter button or press R2 on your Steam Deck. You can exit back out of the on-screen keyboard by pressing B. You should now see a single app called Chiaki NG. Double tap it to open its store page. Once on this screen, click the Install button in the top right corner. This install process should only take a couple of minutes. Once done, you should see Launch appear in the top right corner. You'll want to click this button to launch Chiaki so we can do some initial configuration. The first time Chiaki launches, it will ask if you want to set up an official Steam artwork and pre-configure the recommended controller layout. We highly recommend that you do this, so select the Yes option. If you find your mouse being unresponsive, hold down the Steam button, then use the trackpads. This next screen will allow you to change the name that Chiaki will use within Steam. To stick with the default, just click the Create button in the top right corner. You should now see a pop-up that basically lists everything that the client just did. Essentially, all it did was add itself to your Steam library and also set a custom banner. To proceed, click the Close button. You now see a message saying that you need to restart Steam to see the new Chiaki entry. This doesn't matter as we'll be returning to gaming mode later, so just click the Close button. You'll now be prompted whether you want to enable the Remote Play via PSN functionality. We found this functionality just didn't want to work properly, so in our case, we'll be selecting the No option. You'll now see a list of PlayStations that your Steam Deck can see using the Chiaki software. Double tap the one that you intend on using. There are two different ways that you can set up your console through this. One is to log in using your PSN account, and the other is to get the base ID by clicking the Public Lookup button. For this guide, we will be selecting the Public Lookup option. When we tried PSN login, the web browser just refused to accept our username and password. Now on this next page, tap the username box and press the X button to bring up the on-screen keyboard. Type in the username belonging to your PSN user that is connected to your PlayStation console. In my case, this is Def1Droid. Once done, click the Submit button. In the PSN account ID text box, you should now see the Base64 of your account ID. If this has worked properly, we can now move on to getting the Remote Play PIN from your PlayStation. For this guide, we'll be getting the PIN from our PlayStation 5. Essentially, this PIN is what allows the connection between your Steam Deck and your PlayStation so that you can remotely play your games. Now on your PlayStation, change to the settings screen. Next, go down and select the system option. Now, select remote play. Now first, you'll want to select the enable remote play option. In here, make sure that your user is toggled on. Now back out and select the pair device option. This next screen gives you a PIN code that you'll need to enter into your Steam Deck. This is essentially what authorizes and allows the Chiaki client to communicate with your PlayStation. Now, back on your Steam Deck, tap the Remote Play PIN text box and press the X button to bring up on-screen keyboard. Now type in the Remote Play PIN that is currently being displayed by your PlayStation. Once entered, press B to exit out of the on-screen keyboard. Next, ensure the console option has automatically selected the correct console that you're trying to remotely connect to. In our case, it has successfully identified our PlayStation as a PS5. Now that we are done, all we need to do is click the register button in the top right hand corner. If everything has worked properly, you should see a message saying "Register successfully received response." Now click the close button to return to Chiaki. You can now see that our console was successfully registered. If we double tap it, we'll begin automatically streaming our PlayStation 5 to our Steam Deck. Well, we can quickly now explore around and make sure that all the controls are working properly. Now that it seems like everything's working, we'll close out of Chiaki for now by tapping the X in the top right hand corner and then selecting No to sleep in the console. At this point, we can now return to gaming mode by double tapping the return to gaming mode icon on the desktop. Now that you're back in gaming mode, let us launch Chiaki so you can begin streaming your PlayStation games directly to your Steam Deck. To access this Remote Play client, bring up the Steam menu by pressing the Steam button on your Steam Deck and then selecting the Library option. Next, navigate to the Non-Steam tab by pressing R1 on your Steam Deck. Once you're on this tab, you should see an item labeled Chiaki NG. Select it and then click the Play button on its Steam page. Once Chiaki has started, you should see the console that you registered earlier. You can now navigate this menu using your Steam Deck control. So select it and then press the A button to begin streaming your PlayStation to your Steam Deck. Here you can see that we are now successfully streaming our PlayStation directly to our Steam Deck. To test this out, we're going to launch the game called Astro's Playroom. This is a great game to test out the game streaming functionality as it relies on a lot of unique functionality of the PlayStation 5 controller. With the game now streaming to our Steam Deck, we quickly can tell that most of the controllers seem to be working perfectly fine. If we swipe up on our Steam Deck, we'll actually be able to replicate the same functionality as swiping up on the PlayStation 5 controller. The latency feels barely noticeable, which is quite impressive. Hopefully at this point, you will have also successfully managed to start streaming your PlayStation to your Steam Deck. This functionality is incredibly useful, especially if you want to be able to play your PlayStation games while on the move around your house. If you have liked this guide, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.